is the second annual Young Artist Competition from the Chamber Orchestra of the Springs in partnership with the Pikes Peak Music Teachers Association. And from the Chamber, I have Pam Chadden, also Mary Beth Schaefer and Margaret Presley, both from the Pikes Peak Music Teachers Association, and both of them having winning students in last year's competition. And welcome, everyone.
Hi,
thank
Keith.
You. Thanks. Thanks for having us.
Who wants to tell me about the Young Artist Competition?
Thanks, Keith. We're so excited to offer the second annual Young Artist Competition to the community. It is open to students up to age 18 in Teller, El Paso, Fremont, and Pueblo counties of Southern Colorado. We are offering this for string, piano, woodwind, brass, and percussion musicians to come and audition, performing a movement of one of a standard concerto or a concert solo on March 21st. Is the competition all day that will run, and then the winners will be chosen to perform with the Chamber Orchestra in concert for a showcase performance on Saturday, May 30th.
That's wonderful. So that's quite a thrill. I'd like to ask you about what happened last year at the winner performing at the Chamber concert. Who wants to tell me about that?
Or winners. Mary Beth, go ahead.
I'm sorry, winners.
Okay. Well, it was a fabulous experience for six of the students that were declared winners, which that's very actually unusual in a concerto competition because typically only one student is selected to perform with the orchestra. Mm-hmm. So that is just, you know, an expanded opportunity. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. I think our youngest student was 13 or 14
who
got
13,
to perform,
yes, 13,
which is very exciting.
Nice.
And the students had two rehearsals with the orchestra, and I must say that Maestro Wilson was just exemplary in working with them. They were very comfortable. My student had a great time at both rehearsals, didn't feel in the least intimidated, and I just really enjoyed and was euphoric over the entire experience from the audition on through the performance.
And such a thrill to perform with the Chamber, like in a real setting like that,
exactly.
In that venue. Would you like to tell me more about your student?
Okay. So Sohee Kayla Yang is her name, and she's originally from Korea. They just immigrated here a couple of years ago, and she's a very special hard worker and takes a couple of lessons a week, as I think Margaret's students maybe take them every day. Because these students that are truly, truly serious about pursuing a performance career, it requires just hours and hours of their practice and teacher work, and just their repertoire is just so extensive.
Well, Margaret, how about your student?
Oh, Emma. Emma Johnson was one of the first place winners. I'm a violin teacher.
All right.
And Emma is this absolutely incredibly wonderful violinist who is very artistic and expressive in the way she plays. The piece that she played was called Lark Ascending by Vaughan Williams.
Yeah.
And she played it as if she were the bird. So we're so proud of her. And it's such a wonderful experience to be able to solo with an orchestra. It's very, very different than playing with a piano.
Mm-hmm.
Because
there
are all the different kinds of sounds around you, and you have to sense what's going on.
Yeah. That's one thing. A student performs by themselves or in small groups, but there's a whole difference in performing with a larger orchestra or a chamber ensemble.
It really gives the students the opportunity to experience what it's like to perform with a symphony, you know, full orchestra, full chamber orchestra in this case, and helps them move to that next level of competitions and moving on in their advancing in their career.
What was the genesis of this competition? What got this started?
I moved from Seattle. This is Margaret. I moved.
Margaret.
In Seattle.
This is your baby.
In 2016. And one of the things that I wanted to do here as a partially retired person was to find out what the teachers in Seattle wanted, in Colorado Springs wanted, as opposed to what I'd had in Seattle. And they said that if there were anything, it would be performing opportunities. So 18 string teachers and I met about how to brainstorm ideas that could actually happen. And one of the people that was there is Emma Patterson, who's one of the board members of the Chamber Orchestra and also a cellist in the Chamber Orchestra. She said, well, when I was in Utah, one of the things of the highlights of my life as a high schooler was to be able to play in a competition in which six winners performed after winning. And so we thought, well, that would be a really great idea. So she proposed this to the board, and it was accepted. Mm-hmm. And so from there, it took about a year, I think, to put it all together. And we ended up with this incredible first year competition. It was really, really wonderful.
We really came out of the gate strong with the
high level
of 25 applicants. And I tell you, all 25 of those applicants were, those students were just of just the highest level of preparation and repertoire choices for the competition. Our judges from last year will be the same this year, and that will be Maestro Thomas Wilson, our concertmaster Jacob Klock, a retired oboist and conductor in town, Don Yeager, and educator and pianist Sarah McDaniel. And so we came out of the gate with those four judges, which we'll have again, and 25 really strong applicants.
I'd like to give out some information here. Application forms and more information at chamberorchestrathesprings.org.
Yes, everything is on the website.
Applications are being accepted right now.
We are open.
Okay, and the deadline for entry is January 31st of 2020. That's midnight Friday, January 31st of 2020. Mm-hmm. And again, the competition date will be Saturday, March 21st of 2020 at Broadmoor Community Church. Mm-hmm. And then the winner will perform with the Chamber Orchestra.
The winners.
Okay.
And we anticipate, again, to rank multiple winners as we did last year, depending on the timing of the repertoire of those top-placing competitors, that there will be multiple opportunities.
Let's touch on something that I like to address every time we talk about stuff like this with, you know, kids and performing and competition and things like that. It also teaches a lot of social skills, like showing up on time and performing in a group and things like that.
I think this is an amazing opportunity for all kinds of life skills for these students, you know, that they're taking away things that they can carry over to all aspects of their life in terms of having to prepare.
They become leaders. They're teaming with the conductor. Mm-hmm. They're teaming with the people behind them. You know, it's just it's a really wonderful effort that way.
Wouldn't you say that's the ultimate in teamwork is performing? With a group, you know, musically like that, where everyone has to be just right,
It does,
Yes, absolutely. I also think that there's the doing the competition gets them, well, for pianists, and I'm a pianist. It gets them around their peers and other instruments, and just that social time of waiting to go out to play in the competition setting itself, and, you know, hearing outside the door how other people sound, that's a great growing experience. And I personally feel, in terms of performance, that in regards of what career they go into, it is the best preparation for doing job interviews, right?
Right.
And even if they, you know, they go to be professionals, that's an extremely competitive field.
Absolutely.
Musician, so.
But it helps them to, you know, to start at this competition and then moving to higher level competitions. And so they have something on their resume saying that they have accomplished, been a winner of this competition and then moved on. And it gives them that confidence to move on to other competitions.
I also understand there's an application fee. Mary Beth, would you like to tell me more about that?
Sure, absolutely. The application fee is actually extremely low for a competition like this. And if students apply for typically that level of competition on a regional or international level, they're talking hundreds of dollars. So, but Chamber Orchestra of the Springs is absolutely fabulous in their outreach to the community. As a member of Pikes Peak Music Teachers Association, that we've just partnered with them, but not financially on this enterprise, that the, honestly, the application fee does not cover the cost of running the competition and doesn't touch on covering the expenditure of the winner's performance and hiring the orchestra for this event. So we would just really welcome anybody who would love to contribute and make a donation to Chamber Orchestra of the Springs for this event. And if they would just make a note in the memo line that they would like it to go towards this young artist competition, that would be greatly appreciated.
Yeah, we're looking for any sort of sponsors and support from the community to help grow the competition. We will gladly receive them with open arms.
Okay. Information about the application fee, chamberorchestrathesprings.org. It's the second annual Young Artist Competition, and applications being taken right now at chamberorchestrathesprings.org. Information and application forms at that website. Any questions? 719-633-3649 or chamorch@gmail.com.
That's right.
And there we go. I've been speaking to Mary Beth Schaefer and Margaret Presley, both of the Pikes Peak Music Teachers Association. Now, this is hosted by the Chamber Orchestra in partnership with the Pikes Peak Music Teachers Association and Pam Chadden from the Chamber. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks so much,
Keith. Thank you.
Thank you.